Hi again, everyone. Chris Tisdell here again. In this presentation, I'm going to continue my series of videos that give a gentle introduction to complex numbers. Now, in previous presentations, I showed you how to add and subtract complex numbers, and also to how to multiply a complex number with a real number, and I talked about the geometric meaning of these operations. In this presentation, I'm going to go one step further and talk about how we can multiply two complex numbers together. So I'll show you how to do it, I'll do an example, and I'll also discuss the geometry so you have some idea of how to visualize what's happening with this multiplication. So let me share my screen with you and we can get started. Okay, now multiplication of two complex numbers together involves a natural distribution, as I'll show you, and really rests on the idea of this imaginary unit I satisfying I squared equals negative one. So let's talk about a quick example. I'll do one by hand in a minute. If z is 2 plus I and w is 1 plus I, then what is the product? Z times W. Okay, well, let's write it out in the Cartesian form. And you would distribute it in the normal way. Okay, so that times that, plus that times that, plus that times that, plus that times that. Now, I've only drawn in two links here where you multiply the real parts together and also the I terms together. Now, those two multiplications will give you a real number because I squared equals negative one. The other terms can be grouped together as well. So the 2 times I plus the 1 times I. Okay, so here I've grouped those together because I know they're going to just be a real number. And I've grouped those together because I know they're going to give me something involving I. Okay, now the first few times you do these problems, you might not want to do that. It's up to you, whatever you feel more comfortable with. But this certainly will save you time and it's quite pretty. Okay, so 2 plus I squared is negative 1, so I'll get 2 minus 1 here. Here I've got 2i plus I, that'll be 3i. So this will simplify down to a 1 plus 3i. So for these two complex numbers, 2 plus I, and 1 plus I, their product is 1 plus 3i. Okay, so I'll do an example in a second, but let's just talk about the geometric interpretation of multiplication. Now, here I claim the geometric interpretation of multiplication of two complex numbers together is seen through a rotation and a stretching or compression. Okay, let me show you what I mean with this example. So let's plot in the complex numbers z and w in the complex plane. So I'll go over 2 units and up 1 unit to plot in my z point. And for w, I'll go over 1 unit and go up 1 unit. Okay, what about z times w? Z times w is at 1 plus 3i, so over 1 and up 3. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is just draw a little line segment from each of these points to the origin. That'll help me illustrate the geometry a little bit better. Okay, and lastly, that one. Okay, so here we have Z, we have W, and we have ZW. Okay, now, first of all, the lengths. If I compute the length of this point to the origin, say by using Pythagoras, and the length from this point to the origin, again using Pythagoras, I'll get two values, And if I compute the value, the length from this point, the product to the origin, this length will be the product of those two lengths. Okay? So W will be something like root, the length of this line segment associated with W will be something like root 2. The length of this line segment will be something like root 5. And the length of this line segment will be something like root 10. Okay, so root 2 times root 5 equals root 10. Okay, that's just using Pythagoras. Okay, so the first bit of geometry here is that if you multiply two complex numbers together, their lengths, the product of their lengths gives you the length of the new product. Okay? And secondly, I can compute the angle to the positive real axis of Z and W just by using trig. Okay? Now, the angle of Z plus the angle associated with W is going to be the angle of ZW. Okay? So there's two bits of important information there. The product of these lengths equals the length of the line segment associated with the product of the two complex numbers. And the two angles to the positive real axis associated with each of these little line segments of the complex numbers, if you add them together, then you get the angle of the product of the two complex numbers. Pretty cool. Now, I'm not going to talk about that in too much detail in this presentation because it's an elementary one. But when we move on to different forms of the complex number, we're going to use that those ideas all the time. Okay? And the nice thing about knowing the geometry of the multiplication is, you know, if you're given two complex numbers and you sort of draw them in the complex plane, you kind of should know where you should end up with the product. So it's you know, you can know if you make a mistake or not. Okay, so to me that's really cool, and we'll get back to that a bit later. But let me do another example by hand, okay? If Z is this complex number, calculate the square of that complex number and plot the original complex number and its square on the same complex plane, or the same Argand diagram as it's sometimes known. Okay, so here we're sort of squaring Z with itself and also taking a power. Okay, so let me work that out for you, and I'll draw a picture in a minute. So Z squared is just Z times Z. So that is negative 2 plus 3i times negative 2 plus 3i. So let's distribute that in a normal fashion. Okay, I'm going to do the real parts first. Okay, and group them together. So I'm going to get negative 2 times negative 2, that's going to be 4, plus 3i times 3i, so that's 9i squared. And what have I got left? Well, it's the usual story. I've got negative 2, 3i plus negative 2, 3i, which is going to be negative 12i. Okay, now remember, I squared equals negative 1. So this will become 9 times negative 1. And if I clean that up, I'm going to get negative 5 minus 12i. So if that's my complex number, then if I square it or I multiply the complex number with itself, I get negative 5 minus 12i. So let's move on to the second part and plot these two complex numbers on the same complex plane, which is sometimes called an Argand diagram. Okay, so let's go negative 2, 3i. So I go negative 2 on the real axis and 3 units up the imaginary axis, so it might be about there. And what about the square or the product? I'll go negative 5 units I guess 5 units to the left on the real axis and 12 units down. So it'll be something around, get this right, something around here. Okay. So here would be z, and here would be z squared. Okay, now let's look at the geometry for a second. If I draw a little line segment in there, the angle to the positive real axis would be doubled, okay? So let me draw that in, let me show you. Okay, so okay, first off, the length, that length is going to be doubled to get that length, okay? And the angle from here to here will be the same as the angle from here to here. Okay, so basically that angle gets doubled too. So you add the angle to itself and you get the angle of the new complex numbers line segment. Okay, so that's the example. In other videos, I'll talk about division involving complex numbers, and I'll talk about what that means and how to do it. So thanks for watching. If you have any comments or questions, you can put them in the comment section below, and I hope you can join me for my next presentation. Thanks for watching.